When you ask bodybuilders how to build a massive chest, most of them will say, do lots of really heavy bench press. Well, I disagree. There's two types of chest exercises. The first is the pushing type, like a bench press or a push-up. And the second type is a squeezing type, like a pec deck or a dumbbell fly. And you need to do both of these types to maximize your chest development. For me personally, I found the squeezing type to be much more effective to increase mass and strength than the pushing type. People ask what I mean by a squeezing type exercise. And imagine you have a ball between your hands and you're trying to pop it. You squeeze life out of it. That's what you should feel in a squeezing type exercise. And that's exactly what you have in the pec deck. You're squeezing your elbows together, or in a dumbbell fly, where you're squeezing. Just imagine you got the ball and you're trying to pop it. The king of squeezing exercises is the dumbbell fly, which is this motion. And it's easy to do at home. All you need is a set of used dumbbells, so it's perfect for your home workouts. Okay, just these dumbbell flies, we're gonna do them on the floor. If you have any questions about that, please see my video on self-spotting. There's a good reason we do them on the floor. Now, we're gonna bend our knees. That's gonna help force our lower back against the ground to protect our lower back. Tighten your abs. Keep them tight throughout the exercise. And when we do these, our arms are gonna be perpendicular. They're not gonna be down here. They're not gonna be up here, out to the side. And our elbows are gonna be slightly bent. Not bent like this. You see people doing the flies like this. That doesn't do anything. Keep your arms almost straight, but not locked. You don't wanna hurt your elbows. Another point, when you do these, try to keep your shoulder blades together. What I mean by that, so put your shoulders back and do the exercise with your shoulders back. So, once again, knees bent, abs tight, hands out to the side, shoulders back. There we go. Okay. So we're going to pick the weights up. We're going to do these really slowly. And when we get to the top, we're going to squeeze. What that helps you do, it helps establish the muscle-mind connection. So when you get to the top, squeeze. Now, an important thing, you notice I'm doing these with my arms out. If you bend your elbows at 90 degrees like this, this is really easy. I could do 5 times as much weight if I did them this way. It's because of leverage. And you have to be careful if you don't want to fool yourself into thinking you're doing more weight than you're doing here. So keep your arms almost straight. Now, you can use this to help yourself cheat a little bit and do forced reps. So say you've done your 6 reps, you can't do anymore. So now what you do, bend your elbows a little and do a couple more reps. So it's getting harder, you can't do any more, but you want to do some more forced reps. So bend your elbows a little more. And what this is going to let you do, it's a safe way to do forced reps without a spotter.
Now let's look at how you can take these dumbbell flies and incorporate them into a complete chest workout. First of all, you could just do a chest workout that was only dumbbell flies, and you'd only want to do this now and then to really shake up your chest workout. Let's look at a more typical workout. This is a beginning chest workout, and you would do this 3 times a week. For this beginning chest workout, what you would do is you'd do a set of push-ups, wait 60 seconds, do a set of these dumbbell flies, wait 60 seconds, and then repeat. Go back to the push-ups. And you would do this until you'd been working out 10 minutes. And again, as I said, you would do this 10-minute chest workout 3 times a week for this beginning workout. Now, for an intermediate chest workout, you'd only be doing your chest once a week, but you'd be doing it longer. You'd be doing a 30-minute workout. And this workout would be very similar. You'd do a set of push-ups, wait 60 seconds, do a set of dumbbell flies, wait 60 seconds, and you'd repeat that till you'd been working out a total of 30 minutes. For an advanced chest workout, well, that's the subject of my entire next video.